here in the CIF Southern Section Division 4 boys soccer final, and Godinez, a relative newcomer, just less than a decade in the game. They're ahead of South Torrance 1-0. And how do they get here, David Cullicutt? This beautiful transitional play.
Ryan Abara, look at that leap. Like a salmon, he rose into the back of the net. 1-0, and that's the difference at this point. South Torrance got to find a way to get back into this game, because really that one goal was maybe not even a full reflection of the dominance that Godinez had in that first 40 minutes.
So South Torrance fortunate here in some respects. South Torrance in the dark uniforms with the white sleeves. Godinez in the white. We're here at Warren High School, Downey, California, finishing up a fantastic day of CIF Southern Section Ford Soccer Championships. And a nice save there from Cole Cooch, the keeper for South Torrance.
Yeah, Cooch has been pretty solid. Maybe just the one mistake on that goal by Ibarra. He looked a little hesitant to come for that, and then there was a little altercation at the end of the first half. But other than that, he's looked very solid, just a sophomore.
We talked about Godinez's road here to the championship in that win over Santa Paula. Jose Macias got the game-winning goal with just 16 minutes left. Santa Paula feeling that a bit of a controversial finish. They thought the goalie was fouled during that final play there. No call to their advantage, and Godinez able to hang on for the 1-0 victory, and they reach this championship final years in the making. And we've alluded to the fact they're a relatively new school, only opened in 2007, but David, as you've illustrated throughout the broadcast tonight, this has been something that maybe not inevitable, but certainly in the works for the last few years.
Yeah, this is a team that's been knocking on the door. They started out in 2013, where they had a great playoff run, took it all the way to the semifinals. The following year, to the quarterfinals. Last year, they made it to the semifinals again, so they've been ready. Then this year, of course, they're in the final, and they've got about 38 minutes left to get the first championship, not just in soccer, but the first championship for any sport at their school.
Opening minutes here of the second half, and South Torrance trailing 1-0. And the big development here in the second half is what sort of tweaks can South Torrance make to try and draw level here. The score is one part of it, but just the overall sentiment that Godinez has been controlling the possession is the other. And how does South Torrance sort of break up some of that dominance?
Yeah, Torrance is, they've got to basically squeeze this game into a smaller area of the field. And that's going to expose that back line to the ball over the top, but it's a risk they're going to have to take.
And now they've gotten a small piece of field to work with, but a save is there from Penaloza. So a good clean try from Dara Factori, but turned away.
Yeah, Factori there, he hit that with plenty of power, but lacked the direction. Hit it straight at the keeper, who was able to handle it comfortably. And we talked about Godinez hopefully making history with their first championship, but they're actually hosting several championships. Their facility hosting some of the basketball championship games this weekend, some on Friday night, and championship games today as well. So although they're not competing, they are actually hosting.
Championship fever taking over the campus of the Godinez Grizzlies, and a lot of the students here to support. South Torrance again getting another opportunity, but the Grizzlies laying in wait to force that turnover. Long run here for Ibarra.
Oh, nice play.
He'll turn the corner. Tries to go one-on-one. Lost control, now regathers. Look at Ibarra, one-on-one, and that's deflected away, but some unique individual moves to beat that defender.
Yeah, it's a combination of great foot skills and a real upper body strength. Holds off the player, shields the ball away there, and rolls the ball. Nice skills.
Able to make that turn. Doesn't earn anything at the moment except a throw in here on their own end, on their offensive end, rather. Header in front. deflected out, and Godinez will keep it on the attacking end of things. Float one in front right here. That's in the back of the net. Godinez has another, and it's more Brian Ibarra.
I can't believe how much space he had. There, South Torrance team appealing for an offside play there, but Ibarra wide open. And he's not going to miss from that.
Almost seemed as if time had stopped a bit. He found himself so wide open.
Yeah, the mismatch. Look at that. He's got 10 yards of space. They're raising the hands. They're looking over to the assistant ref. No good. And Ibarra gets the second of the game. Godinez looks in control.
And South Torrance in trouble here. Looking to manufacture something on the offensive end. Spartans push that ball to the far side of the field.
Yeah, Torrance needs something to get back into this. Referee's given a foul. And South Torrance there, hoping they maybe they're going to play advantage.
Ibarra now 28 goals on the year. Just a junior. Have to be pretty surprised if you don't see him at the next level. Long try here from South Torrance. On the money in front. Penaloza comes out, and he will hunt it down, going down to two knees.
Yeah, nice ball in from Dara Fakfori. Penaloza initially was caught in two minds, but able to secure the ball. There goes Ibarra. Good turn of pace. Chad Lagerway's got to come up with some kind of a plan to get his team back into this game.
Header in front and dealt back to Cooch. And perhaps some more chance taking here as we get deeper in this second half. Still plenty of time with over 30 minutes to play, but they are in a 2-0 hole right now.
Yeah, and that's their plan. They're going route one. That was a long punt down the field and chase it, try and win a set play. They got a long throw here.
Throwing here from the far side, directing traffic.
Will Haywood will be a target.
Looking for the header in front. Not available. Dealt back out. South Torrance will keep it alive here. Serving
nice
this one inside.
Behind.
And that's out on the outside of the net on the attempt in close from Noah Harrison. And you touched on Haywood. He's been relatively quiet here tonight.
Yeah, I've been surprised how deep they've played him. They've played him more in a sort of a midfield role. I was expecting him to be a little further forward. I thought they would play him in the kind of same way that Ibarra's been playing for Godinez, really hunting all the balls down on the back line.
Cooch comes out to gather there.
And Haywood's played more of a sort of a number 10 role, kind of attacking out of midfield. I mean, his physical presence, he's certainly won plenty of balls in the air.
That one won by a lucky fan as it skied into the seats.
It almost headed out of the stadium.
And quickly returned. Always nice when folks don't try and keep the game balls.
Nice foot skills. And they got a chance to whip this ball in. The delivery, not what Spartans would have wanted.
A battle for it, and it'll stay with South Torrance.
Sent Fakfori over there again. He can deliver a similar ball than he did last time. He's going to want this to be roughly around the penalty spot, between the penalty spot and the 6-yard area. That's the danger zone. He's got to hit it with some pace, though. If he floats it up there, the keeper's going to come claim it.
And this one is floated, keeper out, batted around, and Penaloza able to get it away from the goal for the moment, but South Torrance keeps on the attack. A couple of headers in front, a chance in close, trying to regather, another try, and cleared away. Godinez coming up with a huge defensive stand right in front.
Oh, that was definitely a chance. But again, that swarming defense. I've been really impressed with the Godinez defense in this game. You know, Ibarra aside, they've really held it together.
So Godinez can settle in here a bit offensively and peel some time away, move the ball around.
Yeah, absolutely. This is their game, and this is where Torrance has got to come out of their shell. They are squeezing the game up a little bit, forcing Godinez into a long ball there, but they were able to pick up the scraps.
Here's a long run for Godinez. Last thing South Torrance can afford is another goal. Spartans on the move. Sending Tanner Nelson, a freshman, on a long-distance journey.
Nicholas Suazo, an uncompromising challenge there in defense.
We talked about some of the athletes we haven't heard from as well. Jonathan Nadeau got the game winner against Valencia in that semifinal for South Torrance. And one of the big things Coach Chad Lagre was looking for was a better start to the game, and they came out, didn't score a goal. They haven't scored yet. So the first half has gone by. They didn't get that better start. They felt like they came out strong versus Valencia, even though they were down early, as here's a corner opportunity in front and push back out towards midfield. But now you have to regroup a bit. You had wanted to have that good start. It didn't come. Now you're in the second half. Where can you go to try and battle back here?
Well, I got to go to Will Haywood. He'd be my guy, and I'm a little disappointed with that corner kick there. You know, he's the target man. He's strong in the air. We just got to send that ball into an area where he can attack it. You know, if South Torrance wants to get back into this game, they've got to look to their leading goal scorer. You know, he's coming in with 11 goals, but they're playing him too deep, in my opinion. You know, at this point, they're chasing the game. They got to push their goal scorer further up the field.
Some nice individual work there from Noah Harrison to try and keep possession alive.
Yeah, Harrison's been a live wire. He's really been up and about that attacking area.
Penaloza tries to slow things down. Tanner Nelson will give pursuit force to pick the ball up. Otherwise, I think Penaloza was happy to run a 30 seconds to a minute off the clock there.
Yeah, Noah Harrison has run all game long. I've been really impressed with his attitude and his athleticism, but he hasn't had a whole lot of support. Times where he's been trying to dribble through four defenders and get knocked off the ball. I think they got to push Will Haywood forward and try and get Noah Harrison to run off some flicks and some little knocks on from Will. With a long ball.
Long try and over the goal. Substitution coming here.
Again, they're not finding their target players.
Andy Sosa will come on for Godinez, a sophomore. Give Richard Perez a break. And how much of not being able to find those target players do you attribute to what South Torrance is doing defensively? Or rather, Godinez.
Yeah, I think they've played the perfect game. Godinez came out with their game plan, and they've controlled the game. They stretched the field. They played the ball from left to right and back again. They've not allowed Torrance to really settle into that game plan. So a lot of the credit goes to them.
And Aloza gathers in front of the goal.
But I do think Hayward's got to stay up and play further up on that offside line. He's been doing a good job in the center of midfield, but at this point, I think they've just got to bypass that, get the ball up there earlier. He's tracking back now. I mean, he was chasing the ball with the goalkeeper in the box. That's where we want him. But now he's back in the center of the field.
South Torrance getting physical here at midfield.
That's offside.
Official there to whistle that one dead.
I'm sure Kuchu watched this towards Hayward.
Let's that one roll quite a bit and drives it all the way down the field. Ball awarded there to Godinez.
Yeah, Hayward showing a little frustration there. Took the shirt right in front of the official.
Nothing lead for Godinez. They've scored their goals in the first and second halves, both thanks to Brian Ibarra. A header, the 10:51 mark of the first half, and then another beautiful delivery with the left where he was left wide open at the 35-minute mark here in the second half. And Godinez now trying to hang on here for their first championship in any sport in school history is Penaloza with the gather. Long run here for Godinez. Keeper out. They deliver to the left side. Ibarra again makes a defender miss and then sails it high. It's deflected back at him.
Right there you see the risk where South Torrance pushes forward, leaves space in behind. That's where they can break. Long ball over the top. An unselfish pass.
And that deflected there off South Torrance. Ibarra wisely fanned out to the near side and created some room on that 2-on-1. Godinez ahead 2-0, but keeping up the pressure. They want to add a third here.
Best form of defense is offense. They still continue to press for a goal. Why not? Super confident, number one ranked team. And playing in front of a packed stand. A lot of support here for the Grizzlies.
Suazo will throw the ball in. Coming near side, headed right in front. Godinez will keep it alive in the attacking end. Trying for a centering opportunity there, and it's pushed out of play. And a corner kick up coming.
Grizzly fans having fun in the stands in front of us.
There's Godinez now with a corner kick. A couple of opportunities at a header. Not to be, but kept alive. Clean look here coming up. Cross cage and then deflected away.
That's a great opportunity. Real composure to play that ball out to the left side.
Edgar Adami, number 10, is eventually going to get control of this one, and he'll look to have all day.
Yeah, nice pass in front of the goal. That was deliberate. That wasn't a shot. He played that in. He measured that ball right in front of the keeper.
I was trying to set up Suazo, who was moving towards the far post. Couldn't connect, but they keep it again in the attacking end. So a lengthy possession here for Godinez.
Godinez going short on that corner kick, maintaining possession. Happy to see the seconds tick off the clock. Here comes Torrance on the break.
South Torrance now looking to advance. As much as they've struggled, you feel like one goal here would really just change their whole outlook.
You know, Tanner Nelson's got a ton of speed. I mean, he's sprinter speed up there, but they haven't been able to break him in behind. I got a feel that, you know, the connection that they needed was Tanner Nelson off Will Haywood. That's where they wanted to be looking for, you know, some kind of a breakout. Noah Harrison as well, a lot of speed. But I think they needed to get Will further up the field and allow him to flick the ball onto those forwards.
Under 20 minutes to go here, second half. Godinez leading South Torrance 2-0. And South Torrance will go to the bench.
You know, Greg, it's easier said than done. I mean,
certainly.
Will's done a terrific job in that center of midfield. Without him in there, I think this Godinez team would be running riot in the middle of the midfield.
Yeah, with the skill in this Godinez team, we talked about the ability to play above their division ranking. 2-0 could easily be more if it wasn't for the efforts we are seeing at South Torrance.
Well, we likened them to Barcelona in the pregame, and they've lived up to their billing. Maybe after the CIF Southern Section 4 championships, they'll be on to La Liga and up against Real Madrid in the next round.
An aggressive travel schedule after their trip here to Downey.
There's a chance here. Haywood peels off to the far post.
Set play opportunity. Inside, in front, headed away, and cleared away. South Torrance with another great striking opportunity. Cannot convert, and Godinez is able to get that one out of trouble. Some bodies hitting the ground here for South Torrance. That's Tanner Nelson going down. And a yellow card. That will go on Andy Sosa, it appears.
Take a look at that Noah Harrison in front of goal. He jumped out of his shoes, but he just couldn't direct it on goal. He almost directed it back away from the goal. I think he kind of lost control of his body.
We didn't see it there, but Nelson taking a shot and Sosa going out. And you're not kidding about Harrison. Some serious elevation, giving up his body. He went up high to try and deliver that header. Frustration probably building here for South Torrance.
Yeah, Jake Prentice there, a little upset. Thought he should have been a corner kick. Wouldn't be the first player to have a disagreement with an official at a soccer game.
Certainly not.
I'd say for the most part, all the games we've watched here at just the stadium today, the officials' crews have been very good. Kept control of the games, made the right decisions.
Yeah, you wouldn't say that any of our games today have been ones that the officials will look back and think they had a bad impact on one way or another. Nice deflection there. Cooch able to push that one out of play on the drive.
He had to move quickly to his left there. It's hit pretty firmly. Yeah, good strike. Good technique, able to parry it away.
Didn't get all of it, but got enough to get rid of it.
See if they go short like they did last time. Looks like maybe just to float this one up to the far post. Nope, drove it in.
Good look in front, but Cooch is there again.
Yeah, and there was a foul there too. Referee waved play on. little rugby tackle from behind.
South Torrance with a throw in coming here on the far side. Another substitution, but they play on for the moment.
South Torrance really got to do something here. Oh, the referee stopped the clock. I think there's an injury, is it?
Like one player was just tying his shoe.
Little unclear what that was for.
There was the air horn for a substitution, but that player never came on, and now we see the substitution. And for Godinez, Eduardo Mata checks in. Wearing number 13, a junior.
Referee indicating an indirect free kick and his hand in the air. Can't shoot direct from goal, but it's too far out really for that anyway. I'm sure they're going to put this in towards the far post and try and get a head on goal. We've got a player down in the penalty box, and the referee stopped the clock again.
So before we could even restart, someone goes down.
And we're down to the last quarter of an hour. Oh, there's
now
a card
yellow
there.
Card comes out as we're getting a little pushing and shoving.
Looks like Noah Harrison picked up the card there. A little off-the-ball incident. Didn't really see what happened. The referee caught sight of it.
Hard to tell which player was down as well. May have been Ibarra. He was in that area.
Ibarra seemed to indicate that he got a little back heel.
They stopped the clock to sort all of this out.
Back to the indirect free kick. Put into the far post.
Good look. And then followed.
Nope.
The flag is up, so this one's coming back.
I got a feeling that hit the crossbar again. I got a feeling that was the football goal getting in the way.
The initial save came from Penaloza, and then there was a second crack at it. Let's see if we have a second look here.
Interestingly, this is indirect. Remember, if this had gone straight in the goal, it would not have counted. Yeah, he tested onto the football goal.
Oh.
Yeah, the goalkeeper could have let that ball go straight into the goal. Would have resulted in a goal kick. He actually chose to tip it.
Goalkeeper instincts there. He's got to go up and get it. Alan Bramian thinking he had a goal for South Torrance, but taken away after it deflected off the football goalpost.
Well, interestingly, if the keeper got the last touch on it and it hit the football post, it should have been a corner kick to South Torrance.
But instead they followed with the goal score that did not count.
Right. And ended up with a goal kick.
So officials maybe missed one there. And now a collision here again, and Tanner Nelson's getting beat up. He hits the turf once more.
Nicholas Suazo in the middle of everything that's going on. Definitely one of the vocal leaders, senior on that defense.
So South Torrance, just moments ago, thinking they cashed in with their first goal. They stay in the hole 2-0 here. And time not on their side with 13 minutes and change, and another one is deflected out of play.
That'll be a corner kick.
Now they'll get that corner kick. But some drastic measures need to be taken here for South Torrance if they want to try and draw even in this Division 4 championship final.
Traveling faithful for the Godinez Grizzlies. And urge them on for a little defensive stand here.
Corner kick coming up.
Goal here for South Torrance would set us up for a fiery last 10 minutes.
And a sub here for Godinez, and that also helps take some time off the clock. Corner on the way, header in front. Still alive, Nelson controlling, deals it back, and Godinez clears it out near midfield. And South Torrance will have to regroup. Here's a long try in front, and Penaloza to the ground to gather, to the delight of the Godinez Grizzlies fans in attendance here in Downey.
Yeah, Rusin had stayed up there after the initial play, the initial free kick, and was still in the box when the ball came in.
A sky-high kick there from Penaloza. Godinez will work with it here. They push it into the offensive end. Now the ball gave them back to South Torrance. Tried a crossing attempt there, deflected. A little pushing and shoving there from Godinez and Edgar Adami.
John Stroud really leaving his heart out on the field, carrying a bit of an injury coming into this game, but he has put 110% into this midfield effort. South Torrance. Fekfori now to deliver another ball into the box. I think we've seen this play before.
Another opportunity here for the Spartans. Long distance delivery on the way in front. Penaloza comes out. And again, Godinez is there. They have had an answer every time, David.
Yeah, they've looked solid. Really been impressed. We've heard a lot about the offense, but it's their defense that's really held it together. Penaloza in goal. Suazo. Martinez. It's part of that defense. Really been impressed.
And the Grizzlies continue to push on the offensive end. Chipping this one high to Ibarra. He pops it free in the middle. Couple of looks here coming now. Ibarra tries to come over. Can't gather. And the Grizzlies lose possession there. And under 10 minutes remain now in this second half. A 2-0 lead for Godinez. We're here in the CIF Southern Section Division 4 final of boys soccer. David Cullicutt, Greg Meskel here with you from Warren High School, Downey, California. Thanks for joining us on a Saturday evening. It's been all Godinez looking for their first title in any sport in school history. Keeper out.
That's going to
be. And what a stop by Cooch coming up big.
You know, if he got his hand on it there, that would have been a red card. Came out. I don't know what part of his body he blocked that Ibarra shot with, but he was way out of his keeper box.
Yeah, well beyond.
Ibarra tried to chip it over him. As he comes out of his box. Oh, right in the face. Oof. Taking one for the team there, Greg.
Cole Cooch, the sophomore. Takes one to the grill here late in the second half.
Yeah, he was so far out of his box there that he had to do something. Ibarra tried to just lift it over him. Would have been in on goal clean.
.30 to play, second half. A couple of substitutions appear to be coming here. Air horn sounds.
Godinez have really lived up to their number one seed. And Ibarra is number one billing. Came in with 26 goals. And now sitting on 28.
Long run here.
Hayward fighting for ball, but well, that's going to be a card, I think.
Frustration boiling over a little bit more there. Dara Fekfori and Jonathan Romero. Romero down.
Referee not reaching for a card. It's take a look at this. You know, he did reach around to try and get to the ball. I genuinely think he went for the ball, but he caught him from behind. That's a free kick, and that's actually a good decision by the official. Grizzly faithful didn't think it was the right call.
And they are working their way into a celebration lather here in the stands, so didn't want to hear any of that as Cooch with another stop.
Barra with the spin and fire there from 22 yards.
South Torrance working in close again. And
Noah Harrison has taken a beating.
He was upended in a major way.
I look at the handball right there. Tempest beginning to fray. The official's going to have to step in.
A little shoving here, and now we're getting a little bit of a melee. And bench is about to clear. Coach is wisely holding people back, and coaching staff's getting frustrated. You can see for Godinez, Ruben Fernandez upset with his athletes, and a red card has come out.
Yeah, Harrison now.
So a red card against South Torrance, and Noah Harrison, he's been sent off for good.
Ruben Hernandez, the coach of the Grizzlies, was off the bench and telling his players to get out of the way.
So things getting physical. You're going to see Harrison come in from the right side. He was not part of this initial melee. He'll just start pushing, and that's an easy call there for the officials. Escalating this matter a little further. And you talked about it. He's taking a beating here. Probably just had enough.
Yeah, he's taken the clattering throughout the game. Put his body on the line, and that's just frustration. Got to stay in control. I mean, there's still time for South Torrance to get back in this. I know there's only 6 minutes, but, you know, a goal here, and we could have all sorts of nervous moments at the end of the game. Now they're down to 10 men. They're not making it easy on themselves.
No, bigger disadvantage to have for the red card to Harrison. Down a man here when they need all the extra personnel they can get.
You know, we talked about the style of the officials' crew. You know, they've pretty much let things go, except when it's really boiled over, where they've stepped in. I don't think that's really favored South Torrance team. Godinez, the stronger team, the more physical team, it seems. They've had the better of those little mix-ups.
South Torrance here trying to string something together, but doesn't seem to be in the cards for the Spartans tonight.
Cooch launches another one.
And Godinez with plenty of help on defense to try and hold off a late rally here from South Torrance, especially down a player. It makes it all the more difficult.
Barrett run offside.
Long run here. Long try. Cooch is there. He's been strong.
Yeah, Cooch was off his line there. I think the goal there was to try and chip the keeper, and he almost hit it too good. He hit it on the ground and needed to lift the ball over the keeper's head. This game threatening to boil over a little bit. There's a few feisty exchanges in the midfield area.
Under four to play, second half. South Torrance has had opportunities. They've had the corner kicks. They've had the direct kicks. This one pitched up high, header over the cage.
That was a chance in front of goal.
But those are the opportunities they haven't been able to convert, and those are the ones you'd suspect they'll look back on and wish they had had a different result, of course.
It's Robert Rusin, the up there as the central defender. Gets up nicely, but just unable to direct the ball down, and floats over the top of the crossbar.
Ball the awarded to Godinez, much to the frustration here of South Torrance.
Yeah, well,
Hayward thought he had a steal.
Not happy with that. The South Torrance team has let their frustration with the officials kind of get into their heads. It's taking them away from what the task at hand really is getting two goals in the last 3 minutes of this game.
Goalkeeper out. Cooch tangled up, and he's able to wrestle that one away. A little words there between Cooch and Ibarra.
It looked like Cooch kind of tackled him there as he was going for the ball.
A second look at this one. That is correct. It's a takedown there from the keeper.
If that was a tryout for the South Torrance rugby team, he just made the first 15.
And so tempers flaring here and hoping this one will expire without any more issues. Godinez is on their way to a championship here. And a history-making performance, then upending right there. Officials letting them play on. Godinez going to win their first title in any sport in school history.
Ibarra's offside.
Ibarra, and Cooch is there for the stop. And then Ibarra falls to the ground, and Cooch will come over.
Ibarra doesn't need to do this. I'm afraid there's a little bit of simulation there. Ibarra stepped in front of the keeper. We had the Oscar Award ceremony last week.
No shot that whatever happened here is as painful as he's making it out to be.
Now, I think Ibarra took a look at him and actually stepped in front. There he takes the shot. He stops.
No way. Well, they won't win the acting awards tonight, but they will win the Division IV crown as Godinez is on their way to victory here. Ahead 2-0, a little over a minute to play, and it's been Brian Ibarra with two goals to lead the way.
Yeah, I think they're going to be sending this championship back to Santa Ana. Little strike on goal. Cooch clears the ball up the field immediately. We're inside the final 60 seconds. Godinez Grizzlies cheering. They believe that they will win. A ball hoofed up the field. Precious seconds ticking off the clock. For Chad Logaway and the South Torrance Spartans, this has just been a game too far. But a terrific season. Of course, they have a great chance of advancing into the regional tournament. But tonight, they just ran into the number one Godinez team that just played like a champion. And that's exactly what they are. As the referee blows the final whistle, the Godinez team celebrate. The South Torrance team fall to the turf in tears. Some remonstrating with the officials. But it is the Godinez Grizzlies come away with the CIF Southern Section 4 Soccer Championship in the Boys Division 4. Two terrific goals by Brian Ibarra. This season, 26 goals coming into the game, 5 assists. Tonight he stepped up and added 2 more to that tally. Terrific play for the Grizzlies. Coach Ruben Fernandez said before the game he was very confident, believed their style of play, possessed the ball, they couldn't be beaten, and he was right. They made the early running. We'll take a look at the two goals. Again, Brian Ibarra. Ball comes in, Ibarra left wide open in front of goal, and he's not going to miss from there. We have the... This is South Torrance. Tipped onto the crossbar. One of the few chances they thought they got the equalizer there, but was ruled to have hit the football crossbar. It was called back. Here we have the first goal from Ibarra. What a great leap. What a great athlete. In front of keeper Cooch. Puts the ball into the net. That was the first goal of the game. And, of course, sealed it in the second half. 2-0 for the Godinez Grizzlies. You know, for a new program, a new school, the first ever CIF Southern Section Championship in any sport, they can be terrifically proud of their achievement. And for Fox Sports West Soccer coverage here on Prep Zone, we're proud to bring it to all their fans. Really caps a wonderful day soccer here at Warren High School at Justice Stadium.